More than 40 million people are under some kind of storm watch on one of the busiest travel days of the year. Cancellations and delays are already piling up at airports and are expected to increase as the day progresses. As Craig Boswell shows us, the nasty weather is also expected to slow traffic as well.
Airports are seeing long lines of holiday travelers watching the weather and the flight status board. A winter storm is hitting the Northeast with rain turning to snow.
1 to 2 inch per hour snowfall rates in New England later on today with that rain snow line hugging the coastline of eastern Massachusetts.
The large crowds and bad weather are already having an impact. So far today, more than 1,000 flights have been delayed and more than 400 have been canceled.
We're ready, just in case there are stranded passengers, we're ready to accommodate them to ensure that they're comfortable.
Some travelers decided to skip the lines at the airport and take the train instead. Amtrak expects today to be a record-setting day for passenger travel.
Sometime I fly, but not today. This is not today.
And with the average price for a gallon of gas at $2.81, the lowest holiday week price in years, the roads are busy as well. AAA estimates there will be 40 million drivers on the highways this week.
We're urging motorists to drive with additional care and allow more time to reach their destinations due to the winter weather that's out there today.
By air, train, or car, AAA says there will be 46 million Americans traveling 50 miles or more for the Thanksgiving holiday, the most since 2007. Craig Boswell, CBS News, Washington.
Fortunately, things here are not as chaotic as some of those troubled spots. This morning, there were only 2 cancellations and just a handful of delays. Most travelers followed recommendations and arrived early, preparing for possible long lines. Despite the threat of severe weather, some passengers we talked to say the threats of delays are still worth traveling to see their families.
It's wonderful to get together with family, and when you're not with them, even though it means traveling, it's sort of sad. So you have to learn to take everything in stride and accept the delays and just hope that they're not too horrible.
You just got to relax. You just got to take it as it comes. You can't control it, so get out your iPhone and play some games. Just wait it out.
If you want to get updated on the status of your flight, we have a flight tracker on our website. Just head to newschannel5.com and click on news links. What was planned as a local candlelight vigil to protest the situation in Ferguson, Missouri, turned into an hours-long demonstration spilling over onto the streets. After making a trip around downtown last night, protesters made it up onto Interstate 24 and closed down the flow on both sides. They did that twice, both times laying in the middle of the roadway for 4.5 minutes to represent the hours, they say, Michael Brown laid in the street after he was shot and killed in August. Traffic was backed up for about an hour. Metro Police say there were no injuries, arrests, or property damage. In contrast, the National Guard was called in for a second night in Ferguson. Police made at least 44 arrests overnight there after anger boiled over in reaction to Officer Darren Wilson's first interview. The man at the center of the controversy says he felt his life was in danger, his conscience is clear, and he was just doing his job. Our Tennessee Titans took time out to focus on the homeless of Nashville. The Titans provided the food for at least a couple hundred people last night, and it was all served underneath the Jefferson Street Bridge. It's a part of a program with the Bridge Ministries and Second Harvest Food Bank.
This is a very important night for us, knowing that we can give back to the community that needs it, and right here in the shadows of LP Field underneath the Jefferson Street Bridge.
Every week, the Bridge crew provides a hot meal and ministers to the homeless, regardless of the weather. And it's not too late for you to partner with us and the Nashville Rescue Mission to help the less fortunate this holiday season. The mission will serve thousands a traditional Thanksgiving feast, but they need your support. If you'd like to donate, just $2.26 provides a meal for one person. You can find more information on our website at newschannel5.com. I'll be back here at 4, and you should be too if some extra holiday cash sounds good to you. Just be the 5th caller when you see the cue to call, and you'll win a $500 Visa gift card. That's later today right here on News Channel 5 and 4.